This is the first episode in a series where I basically take ugly websites and I revamp them to look a lot better and a lot more modern. So I'm gonna take this website and turn it into this website. Okay, so let's just jump right into the video. I'm gonna explain to you guys what this website is and why I changed it and what the changes that I made were. So from looking at it, the URL is 007museum.com and this is a James Bond museum that is located in Sweden. However, this is maybe one of the worst websites that I've ever seen in my life. Obviously, the person that did this isn't a UI designer or a designer of any sort. It's just a fan of James Bond and he decided to create a museum. So this website doesn't really have any reason or basically any structure to it. It's sort of just a really long post. I don't really know what I'm looking at here. And it doesn't even have menus. And if you click on this, it basically reloads the page. And so, yeah, basically it has a lot of work that it needs to be done. So let me just show you guys my process, how I went from this website to this website. Now, the first thing that I did was I created a logo for the museum itself because I couldn't find one it has this one, and I guess that could be the logo. However, I think it could have a better one. So I just created something really simple, which was I created the 007 logo and I merged it with the word museum. And so here we have our brand spanking new logo. This is gonna serve us for what we need. It's just a really simple logo that can be used for this. So the next thing I wanted to do was add a few menus to the website because I saw that, as I said, it doesn't even have any menus. And so, yeah, I looked into what some regular museums may have and what menus museums tend to have. And so what I found was usually they have events, they have a fees page where they explain all the fees that they have for the museum, maybe ticket prices or special prices and fees and whatever. And then maybe I also thought that since it's 007 and James Bond and there has been a lot of movies about this, then maybe we could have a history section, something along the lines of that. And from there, I added this small little burger menu. And I guess what that would be a theoretical sign-up page or a login or maybe just an extra information page like an FAQ or something like that. But it's just tucked away here and we don't really need to worry about that. One of the main things about this website that I wanted to do was sort of take an image from the museum. Like maybe they would have like a really cool car that they have showcased or something along the lines of that, that we could use and benefit from and maybe even use it from our hero. However, if we take a look at the site itself, there isn't actually any image that is hero worthy. So for example, we could have used this image, but it would look kind of weird. And so it really goes on forever. And there isn't really any image from the museum website itself. And so what I did was I went onto the Google Maps listing for the museum, and still I didn't really find any great images that could be used as a hero. I was thinking maybe these ones, but they're not really like up to par for what we want. And so what I did instead was I found this really cool image from Google. Actually, I just looked up, I think, James Bond cast or James Bond, all the James Bond in history or something like that. Don't actually remember. And what I got was this really cool poster, which is all the previous actors that have acted as James Bond. And so what I thought we could do from here is take this image and use it as our hero. Now again, usually I wouldn't do this. It'd be really cool if we could use something from the website itself, like a really cool card that they have or something like that, but again, they don't, so we have to move on with this. So what I did was I added it to the right side and I created this extension to it. This is just a simple rectangle with the same color as the background. And so that kind of splits up our image. Now on the left side, I wanted to have a really simple, just kind of like a 6 or 5 worded sentence that just explains what the place is or like a really cool catchphrase or something like that. And in our case, we have the benefit that this is a movie franchise. And so I thought that maybe there could be a catchphrase that James Bond has, and I came up with two that are the most famous ones. So the first one is the name's Bond, James Bond. We all know that one. And then maybe a lesser known one would be shaken, not stirred, referring to his martinis. So I decided to pick the names Bond, James Bond, because I think it's just more known overall in the world. And so then I went with that one. And so here we kind of see a second tagline, which would be more up for SEO purposes, but just something more that kind of supports what the place is and what the website actually is. And it's not just a James Bond fan page or something like that. It's a museum that's located in a certain place. And so I added the line, visit the home of the world's best secret agent. So something to kind of rope you in to actually want to go visit the museum. And so we left it at that. Now, a little known rule in UI design is that you should never use the direct color of black, because in summary, it just makes your eyes work a lot harder, just because pure black just isn't radiating any light. And so what I did was I color picked a blue from his jacket, and it left us with these colors for our website. One, which is again from the jacket of the current James Bond, because he is sort of the main focal point of this hero image. And two, which is the background of the artist's creation that he did for the poster. So if we take this, we are left with this, which is a pretty cool little poster in itself. It's the menus that we have. It's a little burger menu to look at the options, like FAQs and all that, and that's hidden away. We have our hero, which is all the previous cast members from James Bond. We have a very famous catchphrase, so the name's Bond, James Bond. We have a nice little second tagline that kind of supports what we're doing and explains what the website actually is. So it's a museum website, and you can actually go visit it and things like that. And this is what we are left with. So from now, what we're sort of missing is maybe a call to action. So what I did here on the right is I added a get directions button and a learn more button. Now, obviously this learn more button would automatically scroll or take you to another page where maybe you have the dates and the special events that's happening, and maybe just even what the menus are that can even work. So it's just the extension of what the menus are. And then you have get directions. So this could automatically open up a maps app on your phone or take you down to the further page where it has more information about how to get there, or it just basically something that just tells you where it is and how to get there. And so what I did here was I took the previous colors that we had from the suit and from the background, and I used them as our accent colors for the call to action. This is all with the same font between menus, the first header, the second header, and the call to action. And so in the end, we have this image where if you compare it with what they previously had, which is over here, I'll drag it in, we can see the difference between the new image and the old. Now, maybe I might be crazy, but I think that we did do a better job on this, and I think that it's more enticing for the user that they might want to go see this museum now instead of whatever this website is. And so yeah, again, this image, it's a bit of a shame that they don't have a really cool hero image that we could use, but again, I think this image that I found online does it great. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know what you guys thought in the comments down below. And if you guys want to see more videos like this, then subscribe to see more bi-weekly content. Now I'm officially doing 2 videos a week, which is really cool and exciting. So yeah, let me know what you guys thought, and I'll love to read your comments. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you on the next video.